Hello dear students, today we learn about phylum Cnidaria. So in a kingdom Animalia, the second phylum is Cnidaria. So this is also known as Coelenterata. So the name Coelenterata was coined by Leuckart. So Coelenterates are mostly marine animals except Hydra. So Hydra is the freshwater Coelenterate. So they are solitary or colonial. Solitary means they live as a single independently. So colonial means the organisms lives in groups. So that is known as colonial. So sessile or free swimming. Sessile means mostly Coelenterates are sessile animals. Sessile means sedentary. They stick to a substratum and live the life. Free swimming. So with the help of locomotory organs, they swim to one place to another place. So such type of Coelenterates are known as free living. So sessile means sedentary life. So the symmetry of the Cnidarians is mainly radial symmetry. So we all know the definition of radial symmetry. If we cut an animal in any axis which pass through the center of the animal, then the animal can be divided into two equal halves. Such animals, such symmetry is known as radial symmetry. In Cnidarians also, symmetry is a radial symmetry, except in sea anemone, it is a biradial symmetry. So sea anemone can be cut into two equal halves. So like this, and also like this. So that is a biradial symmetry. So the organization is a tissue level organization. So these are the metazoans which show the tissue level of organization. Next, these animals are diploblastic animals. Diploblastic means two layers. So outer epidermis and the inner gastrodermis. So these two layers are outer ectodermis and the inner gastrodermis. So between the outer epidermis and the inner gastroderm, there is a gelatinous layer which is known as mesoglia. So if we draw a polyp, so the body cavity, so this is the body cavity and this is known as gastrovascular cavity or the Coelenteron. So this cavity is useful for digestion and the circulation. So the single opening, so here single opening is present. This opening is known as a mouth. So this mouth is useful for ingestion and also egestions. So there is only one external opening. So that's why ingestion and intake of the food takes through this opening, and egestion of the food material also occurs by this opening. So there is no anus in these animals. That's why the mouth act as an ingestion and egestion. So next, the digestion of these animals is extracellular and the intracellular. So extracellular means the digestion occurs in the gastrovascular cavity. Intracellular means the digestion occurs in the nutritive cells which are present in the endodermis. Next, the nervous system. So the nervous system is a primitive type of nervous system with the neurons. Neurons are present and they are arranged like a net-like structure. So if this is a polyp, neurons arrange like a net-like structure. So and that is known as a nerve net. So next, sense organs. Here the sense organs are absent in polyps, but they are present in the medusoid form. So those sense organs are the statocysts, so which are helpful for the balance. So next, the these Cnidarians show polymorphism. So polymorphism means the body form occurs more than one form. So body forms are two here. Two body forms are present. One is a polyp and the second one is the medusa. So polyp is a cylindrical in structure. So this is a cylindrical structure and it is a sessile. So it attaches to the substratum and leads a sedentary life. Example, Hydra. So these polyps undergo asexual type of reproduction. Next, medusa. Medusa are umbrella like structures. So medusa are umbrella like structures. So this is the umbrella like structure or saucer like structure, and these are free swimming forms and they reproduce sexually. So they form the gametes, and the union of gametes is known as syngamy. So they form polyps by sexual reproduction. Examples for medusoid form is Aralia or jellyfish. Polyp form is Hydra. Famous example is the Hydra. So, so the cnidarians consist of special characteristic cells which are present in the ectodermis, and those are known as the cnidoblast cells or the stinging cells. So that's why the name cnidaria. Okay, so these cells are helpful for the defense and for offense and for capturing of the prey, and also for locomotion and anchorage. So these are also useful for locomotion. So these are the functions of the cnidoblast cells. So these are the special cells or the characteristic cells which are present only in the phylum Cnidaria. So these cells consist of a sting which bites the prey or the other animals. So like that they are for defense and offense. So these cells paralyze the prey with the help of stinging cells. So these stinging cells contain a poisonous substances which is known as hypnotoxic substance. Metagenesis. So we all know that cnidarians consist of two body forms, polyp and medusoid form. Polyp reproduce asexually and produces the medusae, and medusa reproduce sexually and produces the polyp. So if cnidarians exist in two body forms, so polyp and the medusa, so they alternate each other. So that is known as metagenesis. Cnidarians which exist in two body forms and exhibits alternation of generation. So polyps gives medusa and next medusa gives polyp. So this is known as metagenesis or alternation of generation. So example for that is Obelia. So in Obelia two body forms are present. Polyp form is present and medusoid form is also present. Next, sex. These animals are monoecious animals. Both male and female reproductive organs are present in the single individual. Development is indirect type of development, and they consist of a free swimming larval form which is known as planula. So next, some cnidarians are cylindrates form corals, colonies. So coral forming cnidarians consist of skeleton, exoskeleton, which is formed by calcium carbonate. So jellyfishes which doesn't consist exoskeleton, that's why they are very soft. So coral forming, so the coral, so we used to wear the corals in Mangalsutra Indians. So that coral is coming from these cnidarians. Okay, so this is very important. The exoskeleton in corals is formed by calcium carbonate. Examples for cnidarians are Physalia, it is known as Portuguese man of war, and Adamsia, Gorgonia, Hydra, Obelia, etc. So these are the some of the examples of cnidarians. Hope you understood the cnidarian characters. Happy studying.